Zimbabwe National Netball Team 2019. Hashtag telling our own stories.
In conclusion, Your Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, permit me to emphasize to our esteemed guests that despite the recent developments, Zimbabwe remains an exceptionally safe and peaceful country, which is a Zimbabwe is a country whose constitution provides for the rights of the contributing to Zimbabwe's Vision 2030, targeting an upper middle income economy. It is my hope that the world travel, trade and media will work with us as we seek to reposition Zimbabwe on the tourism global market. We are now more open for tourism, trade and indeed for
welcome you to this fantastic city. This city is an all-welcoming city. Edwin mentioned in 2008 we were capital of culture. And then we coined the phrase the world in one city. Notwithstanding the problems of the past, Liverpool is that one city that has stood up and apologized for slavery. Liverpool is on the right path. Liverpool is moving forward at a pace which is mind-blowing. The Liverpool Commonwealth Association sits in the middle of that because we are now seen as that partner for cultural exchange, bilateral trade, educational exchange, female empowerment, gender equality. We are sat around the table when the city now makes all its strategic decisions. And that's the reason why Netball World Cup was bidded for. It's one of those few international events that are predominantly Commonwealth countries. And I look forward to welcoming Zimbabwe back into the Commonwealth family. Only 2 months ago, when you had your disaster in Southern Africa, Cyclone Idai. The Liverpool Commonwealth Association got together with British Red Cross and did a fundraiser to raise funds for victims of Cyclone Idai in Mozambique, Malawi, and Zimbabwe. We weren't saying, well, we're not going to do Zimbabwe because Zimbabwe is not in the Commonwealth. We see Zimbabwe as a Commonwealth country. And we know the process has started, and it's only a matter of time that that process will be completed. But there is still a bit of lobbying work to be done. And from a Liverpool perspective, I considered it a no-brainer that we should be here. We should be present. When the videos go out, when the photographs go out, you will see that Liverpool Commonwealth Association is standing tall with the ambassador of Zimbabwe on a stage in Liverpool. And we will use that platform. I know this is about netball, but we will use that platform to continue to empower and to influence. Because that is what you women are doing. You are inspiring a generation. I also sit on the Netball World Cup Legacy Group, and we had various conversations of what would be the legacy of the Netball World Cup in Liverpool, and we're talking about getting more young people, young ladies into sport, not just netball, but sport in general. But we wanted to make the sport in the UK more attractive to young Black girls, because that is not happening. So when I will be seen photographed with the gents, a proud team of beautiful Black women, I want that to be seen as a means by which we can inspire young people in this country, but also right across Africa. And on that note, ladies and gentlemen, I will end the official welcome to Liverpool on behalf of Karamina, who is no longer here, but on behalf of the Liverpool Commonwealth Association. We are proud to have you. We are proud to be in your presence. And may you do the best you possibly can and make the of Liverpool.
Very much. We appreciate the business community here, and allow me to also speak about the business community back home. We would like to thank Econet Wireless through their brands Cassava Smart Tech and Econet Wireless. You will see the kits that the girls will be playing in. Their playing kits was sponsored by Econet Wireless and sponsored by Simbisa Brands. That is Chicken Inn. The Chicken Inn brand is what their official playing kit, the girl that they'll be wearing. We've got National Foods that also donated and sponsored this team. So they're using the brand Palenta, the Palenta brand. We've got Nyarazo as well. They came through and supported the girls right from the beginning. All these corporates, all these teams, we would like to thank them for the great for supporting the girls. And we've also had notable people that have been working hard here. Allow me specifically Mandy and Judith, please stand so that everybody can see you. These are part of the organizing committee. Mandy is a great person of the organizing committee. They've worked tirelessly from the beginning to raise funds, to organize and make sure that we interface with corporates. Thank you very much, ladies, for your great work. Thank you very much. Let's give a big round of applause, please. So, that said, from the...
And judging from your performance at the continental level, you are very capable of leaving an enduring mark on the global stage, doing the country and continent proud, and keeping the flag flying high. First, I wish to acknowledge the financial, moral, and material support given by government to the national team. The mobilization efforts of the ministry and then the Sports and Recreation Commission, as well as the Zimbabwe Netball Association. So the First Lady herself, Amai Auxilium Mnangagwa, leading the corporate world and civil society in fundraising for this very important international engagement. And I saw that, you know, those who were involved, the ladies in the front table here, were introduced, were very, very, you know, active in mobilizing and fundraising for this very important engagement. Secondly, let me salute our corporates and individuals in the diaspora community for coming on board to support the team. Let me warmly express our heartfelt gratitude to Mr. Peter Pemberi of Express Links International, Mr. Byron Fondira, Director of Chilton Support and Housing, Mr. Jeff Matzingo, the Chief Executive Officer of the Diaspora Funeral Cash Plan, Mr. Trevor Mapondera, who has come with Mrs. Mapondera and the family here, Founder and Chief Executive of Nestline Healthcare Group, Ms. Jonathan Julian, the founder of Ziwa, Choice 24, Ndlovukazi, ZimThrive. I can go on, the list is quite huge, but I'm delighted that the Zim Achievers have been able to you know, coordinate this very important team who have you know, made a very positive contribution to this event. I urge the GEMS to now focus on the single task ahead and continue to work collectively as a team, as expected by our people back home and the diaspora community across the globe. Without teamwork, you cannot succeed, and I exhort you to embed it in all your endeavors. You must work for each other to win the trophy. That's the teamwork we're expecting from you. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I wish to appeal to all Zimbabweans and all well-wishers to rally behind our team and passionately support them as they strive to make us all proud. There is no doubt in my mind that spirited support for our gallant team during the tournament will surely spur them on to deliver the trophy for Zimbabwe. You are indeed our greatest brand ambassadors. Wearing the Zimbabwean jersey must come with national pride. I'm sure and confident that you will all be at your best behavior to promote the country's image and carry the hopes and aspirations of millions of our people. I must applaud the achievement to reach this state of world netball, as this has drawn the attention of the country to women in sport. I know the GEMS have started to attract lots of interest and more followers, as was being indicated by Mr. Pandu here. We must equally applaud corporate partners who have been there to support women in sport so as to carry over to the next generation. I must thank the GEMS, who are the trailblazers in netball. We have created a towering beacon for our young girls to emulate. Because of them, all our girls believe they can do it too. Mr. Pandu was just sharing with me earlier on that she has been inundated with calls from mothers. I've also got this daughter, I've got that daughter, I've got this one. They can't sleep, they're talking about the netball. I mean, they're not yet at your level, but they want to play, you know. So it's important just to keep that you know, spirit of motivation on the basis of what they are seeing from the GEMS. Young girls need to see sport as an essential part of their lives, and having women competing in sport at the highest level, which is where you are right now, should provide role models to inspire and motivate them. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, as you know, sport and recreation play a significant role in human development. By contributing to creating an environment which people can fulfill their potential, full potential, and lead productive and creative lives through social cohesion in accordance with their needs, their competencies, and also their interests. They are a key element of the social development.
Now, when we received a call from Conrad via our brand ambassador, King Alfred, for supporting the GEMS, our immediate response was, yes, we are going to do that. To us, it's more than corporate social responsibility. It's a national duty, it's a national service as a Zimbabwean. When we pull resources together, when we come together and support this
of Zimbabwean history, that's possibly because they've passed through Liverpool. And of course, as an historian, I am an authority on these things, and I would just like to say to the GEMS that you have made history! I'm not just an historian, I'm also from the Britain Zimbabwe Society, which is a friendship society that was set up in, I think, 1982, might have been 81, for Brits who had always supported Zimbabwe's liberation struggle to continue to show friendship and support to Zimbabwe. And the BZS still exists, and I just want to tell you again, guys, there is so much support for you out there amongst the Brits, not just the Zimbabweans in the diaspora, but the Brits are absolutely behind you guys as well.